Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to measure angles in Adobe Illustrator. And I wanted to give a shout out to Amy Warren and David Prescott, who showed us how to do this in our Illustrator Facebook group. If you want to join that, the link is in the description below. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to use a protractor image that I found on vectz.com, and I'm going to just pull this EPS onto my Illustrator icon, say yes, and then I'll hit F7 to bring my layers up. I'm going to target the whole layer by selecting this little dot, and then I'm going to knock this down to 20%, and I'll lock this layer. Now I'm going to make a new layer, and I'm going to paste some angles in that I made before. And I'll hit S7 to toggle off the layers. Now there are a couple ways to measure angles, and the ways I'm going to show you are based on how many degrees away from a horizontal line, like a 0 degree line, the angle is. So the easiest and fastest way, in my opinion, to measure the angle of a line is with the line tool. To get to the line tool, you can hit the backspace key, which will also bring you to the line tool right over here in your tools. And we'll want to start at the bottom point and go up. So I'm drawing a line. I clicked and dragged, and I'm getting right up here. And the nice thing about doing it this way is that these will snap. If you have snapping on, it'll snap to that point. Then we release, and I'm just going to hit enter or return. And now we can see that that angle is 42.49 degrees. We'll say okay. So it's that easy. Now I'm going to take these angles and put the point right down here on the middle point of the protractor. This will help us to double check the degree of the angle. So let's go ahead and do this one. So I'm going to hit backspace to get my line tool again. I'm going to start from the middle and then work my way up to the end point, and I'll just release and then hit enter or return. And that'll bring up 17.58%. And we can see here that falls right about here, which would be 17%. Now, unfortunately, if we go and do something else, let's say we draw a rectangle or maybe another line, if we get back on our selection tool and click this again, and then click the line and hit return, we are going to get the angle of this line instead. So it doesn't say 17 point whatever percent anymore. So you actually lose that. You have to take note of it right after you make it, because you kind of lose that angle once you go on and do other things. Now, the second way to do this is with the measure tool. And to get to that, you need to get to your eyedropper tool. It's underneath that one. And a quick way to see your eyedropper tool is just hit the letter I. And then you can click on that and see the measure tool underneath. Now, before we draw with our measure tool, we'll want to go to Window and go to Info so we can see what's going on. And we'll do the same thing. We'll start in the middle and work our way up to the end of it. Now, the unfortunate thing is when you use the measure tool, it doesn't snap like the line tool does. So in my opinion, it's probably not quite as exact. But once I release, I can see that angle is 42.487. Now, if you decided to start from the top of the angle and go down, you're going to get a different measurement. For example, this one is 222.49%. So you'll need to be careful of that. Make sure you're starting at the vertex and ending at the outer point, if that makes sense. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.